Hello everybody, we're going to be doing a flow yoga class today. This is for my health yoga. So I want everyone to start in a seated position, a comfortable seated position. So you're welcome to sit cross-legged, in lotus. You're also welcome to sit on your knees, or if you'd like to have any props, if you have a bolster or a block, you can sit it behind you. So I just want everyone to take a moment now. Ground yourself into your mat. Be present. Feel your breath going into your body and feeling it going around into all parts. Feeling it in your fingers, all up into your arms, expanding into your chest. Through your back. Feel your stomach rise and your ribcage expand. Feel the breath just flow through your body. Take this moment to bring your awareness to your breath. If it's in your practice, to set an intention. You will find that your mind will wander throughout yoga, but that is our purpose, is to bring our awareness back and be mindful. So don't get frustrated with yourself. If your mind wanders, just acknowledge and bring your awareness back to your breath. A few more breaths here. Now that you're feeling grounded, I want everyone to breathe in. Big breath in through your nose, and I want you to let it out through your mouth and sigh. Let everything out. The day you've just had, the week you've had. Just breathe in. Breathe out. And again. Get rid of everything that you don't want. Two more. Can feel everybody's energy sinking together. Now together, before we start our practice, I want us to take a moment to take three ums. So I want a deep, big, deep breath in, and on the out breath, we um. When you're breathing in, ensure that you're expanding through your belly, up to your ribcage and through your chest. And breathe in. Seated, we're just going to do a slight little stretch. So rise your arms up over your head. bring left arm down to the ground and stretch over to the side, making sure that you're rotating your shoulder back and feeling this down your side body. If pulsing feels better than a static position, you're more than welcome to do this. Breathe in, lift, and breathe out to the other side. Breathe in, and out. And in, and out. One more either side. And feel your body moving. Feel into your muscles. Feel them stretching. Your hands up, down to breath, and through to heart center. Okay, so we're just going to roll over onto all fours now, which is for our cat-cow sequence. So hands under shoulders, fingers grounded, knees under hips, and make sure that you, when you look back, you can't see your feet, so they're all in alignment. So we're going to breathe in, arch the back, open the chest, drop your shoulders back, lift your tailbone up. Breathe out into cat. Drawing navel up and spreading out through shoulders. Breathe in. And breathe out. Now at any stage, if you feel like you need more movement, please feel free to do so. You may feel like going from looking to one side and stretching. Just make sure when you're doing this that you're keeping it even on both sides. And just feeling your body. One more breath. Now we're going to thread the needle. So lift right end up, open shoulders, and we're threading it through to the other side, placing shoulder down, head resting on the mat. Now you're more than welcome to leave your left hand out in front of you. You can stretch it out. If you need more of a stretch, you can leave it resting down where it was. You're more than welcome to lift it up and tuck it in to the inner thigh. Just a few breaths here. Left arm up, place down in previous position, slowly lift up and place your hand back down. Now we'll do it on the other side, so open up to the left and thread the needle through, resting down and again, picking the option that suits your practice or your arm position. Lifting arm back up and back down into tabletop. Now we're just going to take child's pose for a moment. Widening child's pose, so ensure that your big toes are touching Let your hips go down to your heels as close as possible. Hands out in front of you and lower down. When your hands are out in front of you, make sure you are intenting with each posture. So gripping your hands to the ground and keeping your arms off the mat, feeling that stretch through your shoulders. Placing a third eye onto the mat for grounding and take a few breaths here. Again, if a more flowing movement feels better for you, feel free to slowly rock side to side and feeling it stretch in your hips. Otherwise, if the static posture is better for you, then stay still. From here, we're going to come up, leaving your hands where they are grounded. Tuck your feet, toes under into downward facing dog. Now this is your first downward dog, so feel comfortable. Walk the legs out if you need. Make sure that you're grounding down through your hands, spreading out through your shoulders, pushing your chest through towards your legs, lifting up through your tailbone. Doesn't matter if your heels don't touch the ground. You can start with your knees very bent, or you can have your legs very straight. Whichever is in your practice. Just take a few moments here. Okay, so I want everyone to come up onto their tippy toes and back down. Up tippy toes and back down. Tippy toes and back down. Now from here we're going to roll into a plank. So feel your body roll forward. Be sure that you're engaging your core. From here we can rock from side to side for your shoulders, forward and back. If plank feels better on your knees, come down to your knees. Ensure that you're still engaging through your core. So from here we're going to lean forward so we can come into our chaturanga. Ensure that our elbows are tucked in and down. You can stay here or lower to the ground. So push up into your variation of a backbend. So that can be Sphinx pose where your elbows are underneath your shoulders, hands on the ground. It can be cobra, small cobra pose. It can be a high cobra pose. You can also extend your arms out and lift up this way if that is better for you. Now, if you're finding that your back is really sore, engage through your bum slightly. Otherwise, lower a little bit down to make it more comfortable for you. In, breathe out. Again, if you're very flexible here and you feel comfortable, you can slowly sway from side to side. Be very, very gentle and cautious here. Ensure that you're listening to your body. This is your practice. You do what suits your body. After that, come back down. And we're going to push back up into a plank. And back down into our downward facing dog. Now from here, I want you to lift your right leg up into a one-legged downward dog. Ensure your hips are stacked. We're going to breathe in and bring our right knee to our left elbow. So breathe in, forward, and back up. And into the left, and back up. We're going to breathe into our left again. And place our right foot out to the ground
and lift up into a side variation, side plank. Ensure that you're opening up through your chest and you're not dropping down into your shoulder. Left hand back down, knee through to elbow, back up into three-legged dog. From here, I want you to open your hips, bend through your knee, and reaching your knee up to the roof and looking under your left shoulder to find your foot. Try to keep your shoulders as square as possible in this pose. Now we're going to extend back up and bring the foot through into a lunge. When you're lunging through, ensure that you're not just throwing your foot down. Ensure that you're doing this with intention. So from here, we're just going to slightly stretch our hips to start with. So ensure that your knee is stacked over your ankle. There is not a lot of weight in your hands, but they're there for support. You're pushing back through your heel in your left foot, and you're feeling the stretch in your hips. From here, place our left hand down and lift up through the right hand. Opening shoulders, making sure that they're stacked. Knee over ankle and lifting up through our back knee. And hand back down. Going to do opposite side here. So right hand down, open up through our left. Ensure that you're also stacking and not dumping. And hands back down. So from here, we're going to lift our leg back up into three-legged dog and down into downward dog again. Okay, so repeat on the other side. Lift up, breathe in through to opposite elbow, and back, left elbow, and back, and through to opposite elbow, foot down, and lift up. And come back down, lifting through, and coming back up. From here, opening through our hips, stacking, looking over at our foot, lifting our knee up high, trying to ensure that our shoulders are straight. From here, lift up, and stepping forward in through to a lunge. Again, make sure knee is over ankle, hands you can have them planted or they're just there for support, pushing back through, so you want it to be in one straight line and feeling the stretch. Okay, so again, right hand down, opening up. Ensure your back knee is lifting, engaging through your kneecap. Shoulders stacked. If you find your mind wandering, make sure you bring your awareness back to your breath. Swap sides again. And back down, plant hands down. Back through three-legged, and back to downward dog. Okay, so in our downward dog, we want to start getting static now. So stretching through our body, grounding down through our hands, spreading out through our shoulders, lifting up through our tailbone. Want us to take four breaths here. Feeling your body. Now we're going to do a flow roll through to plank. And back there. So going between downward dog and plank. Feel your body and your spine rolling. Now we're going to run through from here, going in with our right leg high, bringing into the chest, stepping forward into our lunge again. From here, lift our arms up before our body, and coming into Virabhadrasana 1. So here we want to ensure that our shoulders are stacked on our hips, so all our joints are stacked, so knee over ankle. Making sure that our knee is tracking out over our pinky toe, shoulders down away. Coming to warrior two. Again, joint stacking. Making sure on the left back foot, your pressure is down the outside of the foot. Flow through into supported triangle. And back to warrior two. And again, with the breath. Two more. One more. From here, reverse warrior. Ensure that we're feeling a stretch through our side body. Looking back for our hand. Flow back through the warrior two. Breathe in, breathe out, reverse warrior. And flow again. One more. From warrior two. Pigeon toe feet in. I'm going to do a forward fold. So engaging the core, hands out to the side. Slowly fold forward. Ensure that you're putting pressure on the outside of your feet. Once we get down lower, then just hang. Feel this body stretching. Wiggle your head so there's no tension. Nod it yes, shake it no. And rock from side to side if that feels good for you. Just relax. Feel your body. Once you feel that you've got a little bit more fluffy, and you're ready to go again, put your arms out to a T. Lift up, and we're going to do the other side. So turn left leg out into our warrior two. I'm going to breathe in, breathe out, reverse warrior. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Two more. From warrior two, going to supported triangle. Down, open, three, and in. Ensure that your strength stretching through your torso. Open. Three more. one more. Breath in and warrior one. From here, I want you to lower down to plant your hands on the ground and step back through to downward dog. Take a moment here. You're going to roll through again. Plank. And back. And back. Two more. Here, I want you to lower your knees, big toes touching, and to child's pose. Knees closed or apart, hands in front or behind. And again, you can stay static, or I like to rock from side to side when my knees are together. Nice massage on the third eye. So when you're ready, let's sit back up. We're going to come into a camel flow from here. So up, hips step over. You can have your feet untucked or feet tucked. Now from here, we're just going to roll forward, bring our left hand on our ankle. Push our hips forward so they're over and stretch back and roll forward. So it's a flowing movement. With your breath, only go as far as you need to go. Two more either side. A little back bend, so a little bit of a warm up for our backs. So now we can try the real camel. Again, feet can be flat, toes up, or you can support yourself on your back. So from here, just going to have your hands on your lower back like this. Roll your shoulders back and down. The more you pull your elbows back, the more support you're going to have than if they're out here. So making sure hips are stuck, so don't push forward. Okay, you should be engaging through your quads, which will help with your lower back. Option one, option two, or option three, your feet can be on the ground. Just take a moment here. Breathe through this heart opener. Now, if it's easy to come out, hands on lower back, and engage, and push out. Beautiful. Just to counterbalance this, we're going to go back into our child's pose. So you choose whether you want knees together or apart, hands in front or behind. Just take five breaths here. So I just want everyone to come to a seated position on their bum. in the middle of their mat. Legs out. Sit up on your sit bones so you can pull the fleshy away from your thumb. And sitting up and toes flexed. Okay, this will be a flow movement again, or you can choose to have a static posture as well. Okay, so we're just going to be doing our seated forward fold from here. So arms rise and fold.
All that with your breath.
Ensure that you're bending at the hips, not curling over at the back. So bending at the hips. Two more breaths. Last one. So from here, you should just slowly lower yourself down to the ground,
engaging your core.
Slowly, slowly, slowly. Beautiful. Now from here, we're just going to do a slight hip stretch. So I want you to have your feet mat distance apart. And we're going to be doing a little exercise with our hands as well at the same time. Okay? So from here, just going to lean our knees over to our left side. You may sit up like this. Try to ensure that your right buttock is staying on the ground. And just hold this for 5 breaths while we're here. Hands up in front of the shoulders. I want you to squeeze really tight and open hands up. This exercise helps with your forearm strength, which can help you in downward dog and can also help you in all your handstands and your arm balancing postures. So other side, breathe in, breathe out across, 5 breaths again. Beautiful. Breathe in and lift. Now from here, we're going to do a seated four. So we're going to take our right ankle and sit it on top of our left knee and pushing our right knee out to the side. Now, if this is a big enough stretch for you, that's okay. You can also choose to pull this leg in closer. Option two, behind the thigh, leg straight or bend. Option three, you can clasp around the front of your thigh as well. Sorry, the front of your shin. Now, if you need more on the right hip, you can use your elbow to push it out if your anatomy suits. Otherwise, you can hold with one hand and push with the other hand. And 3 breaths in. Going to swap those sides over. So again, choosing what suits your body. Making sure that you're bending back through your feet to protect your knee. No pointing and being back. 2 more breaths. Beautiful. Come back down. Now we're going to go into a bridge pose from here. So ensure that your heels are close to your bum. Okay. Now we do also have a few options again, whichever suits your practice. Option one, hands by the side. Engage your legs. Lift up. Maybe. And breathing out, rolling down vertebrae by vertebrae, feeling it touch the ground. Now, we're going to do this 5 times, okay? First of all, I'll show you the other options. Option two, also you can do this, or you, and then you can clasp your hands,
and roll your shoulders under. And you're more than welcome to hold for the five breaths, or you can roll back down again. If Chakrasana, which is wheel pose, is in your practice, you can come into that. Ensure that when you are doing this that you are making it safely, hands by your ears.
And pushing up, and we'll hold this for five breaths. And coming back down slowly. Again, feeling it vertebrae by vertebrae. Beautiful. After that back bend, we just want to hug our knees into our chest. And again, we can rock from side to side if this feels nice. Beautiful. Now we're going to come into Happy Baby. Again, options for you. You can grab the side of the foot, you can grab the big toe, or you can grab the shin. Whichever is in your practice or whatever feels good for you. Making sure that we're pushing our tailbone down to the ground, that our feet are above and perpendicular to our knees. You're more than welcome to take this in a rocking motion if this feels nice for you, or you can stay in a static position. Ensure that your shoulders are down and away from your neck. Breathing through your posture. Feeling your body. Beautiful. Now, we're going to come into our plow pose from here, okay? So if this is in your practice, if not, you're more than welcome to stay in Happy Baby. Or you can come straight into a shoulder, supported shoulder stand, which we'll come into. So plow, you can start with a rocking motion into plow to engage your core. And you can roll back, up and over. Now, two options with your hand. If you feel comfortable, you're more than welcome to have them on the ground, or you can also have them on your back, coming up on top of your shoulders as much as you can. Just a few breaths here. This is a very nice stretch. If you need a modification, you can't touch the ground, you can bring your knees down to the ground if that's easier, or even just be having your legs bent. Now from here, slowly come up into supported shoulder stand. Engaging through your core. Just to start with, if you're finding it easy, you can flex through your feet, which will help engage through your leg muscles. Play around with your legs if you like. Up to the side. Whatever you like to do. And when you're ready, you can come back down. Whichever way you like, through plow, again, and rolling back up. From here, we're going to come into Malasana now. So feet mat distance apart, close together if that feels better for you, or come into the middle. So whatever feels comfortable for you, ensuring that your elbows are on side of your knee, lifting up through your chest, and pushing out. You should be feeling this through your hips and your groins. No slouching like this. Sometimes people's feet are up like this, which is okay. If you've got blocks available, you can use blocks as well. Just take a moment here.
Beautiful. Now from here, pulling onto one side, onto our toes, stretching out through our right leg. You can place your knee down onto the ground if this is better, or you can also lift up if you want to try balancing on your toes. Hands in a prayer. One more breath. Down, and let's go to the other side. Again, whatever suits you in your practice. Feel free to challenge yourself, but only if you feel safe. One more breath. Beautiful. So from here, plant hands down. We're going to come into a lunge. It's a bit tricky here, like this. And we're going to step our left leg up next to your right leg. Slowly rise, lift arms up overhead. And down through the center. I'll come to the front for you. Now we're going to just go into Tadasana for a moment before we come into our standing postures. So ensuring that your big toes are touching, okay, we're going to work from our bottom up. Big toes are touching, grounding down through all four corners. To know your four corners, lift your balls of your toes, lift your toes up, and you'll feel two on your balls and two on the back. So over your heels, place your toes back down. Engaging through the legs, lifting the kneecaps, engaging through your quads, your glutes. Place one hand on the tummy, one hand on the glutes, and feel it engaged. Sucking up, spreading across through your chest, down through your shoulders, stretching your neck, reaching to the sky with your head, fingers spread out with intention. Going to have 10 breaths here. Eyes can be open or closed. Beautiful, open your eyes. So arms up overhead. Press hands to heart center. So we're going to come into tree pose. So you have your three options again, whichever suits your practice. Option one, the ankle. Option two, the thigh. Option three, in the groin, or you can also do in the groin this way. Whichever suits your practice. If you're doing this, you need to hold your foot, you're more than welcome to, other hand at heart center. Otherwise, hands at heart center, ensure that your knee is going down to the ground. Ensure that you're not dropping in any of your hips and you're stretching up all the way to Father Sky. Hands up overhead. Into exalted tree pose. From here, hands down flat. We're going to slowly lift our knee up, square off through our hips, and we're going to go into a balancing stoop. So slowly transitioning with your body weight, all the way forward, until you look like a capital T. And bring your leg up, forward through again without it touching the ground. Hug your knee into your chest. Stand up tall. Two more breaths. You should be feeling your other leg burning by now. And now sit down. Beautiful, guys. So now we're just going to do the other side. Lifting up. Come coming into our tree pose. And lifting up to exalted tree pose. And whatever that is for you in your practice. If you'd like to challenge yourself, you can look in front of you, you can look up, or you can look at closing your eyes. If you'd like to challenge your balance. Now hands out to a T, slowly lift leg up, squaring up, and transitioning through into a balancing stick. Engaging through your core through all these movements to help you and feel your stabilizer muscles working. Beautiful, back up through, hug knee into chest. Stretching up tall. Beautiful. Now just reaching up again. And we're going to come into our chair pose from here, into a slight twist, okay, before we go back down to the ground. So from here, ensure that your knees don't go past your toes, so you make sure you can still see your toes. And when we're twisting to the side, that we're not bringing one knee out, okay? So hands to heart, right knee, right elbow across, and stacking and opening up. Feel welcome to open your hands up if this feels better for you, or if you'd like to keep them closed. Two more breaths. Come back through to center and across to the other side. One more breath. Beautiful. Back to center and forward fold down to the ground. Shake your body if it feels good. Shake your head, feel it hang down. Beautiful. Now from here we're going to rise up onto our toes, coming up and seeing if we can just balance on our toes for a moment here. Beautiful. And then from there, just come back down onto your mat, lying down on the ground for you. Just take a moment here, take a deep breath in and out. So we're going to bend our left leg, lift our right leg up, and wrap it around. So you can only get it halfway around, that's okay. Some people can also wrap it around. And we're going to bring these over to our left side. You might feel your back crack. And we're going to ensure that we try to keep our right shoulder down to the ground. So you can stretch your arm out if that feels good. The left arm can be stretched or place it wherever you feel is comfortable. And just feel into this stretch. Beautiful. Legs back up and swap your sides over. Beautiful. And lift legs back up. Now we're going to come into our final Savasana. So whatever feels comfortable for you, whether you like to have your legs straight and flat, if you have a bolster near you or a block to put under your head or under your legs, you can come into a bound angle pose if you like to leave your hips open. This feels very nice as well if you've got open hips. Hands can be out to a T, to the side. If your palms are open, this is going to let you receive energy. When you're in Savasana now, you want to make sure that you're relaxing. So we want to take a deep breath in and out. Feel your body melt into the ground. Feel your feet touching the ground beneath you. Feel your legs touching the ground beneath you. Feel your buttocks and back feel supported by the ground. Your shoulders relaxing down. Arms, there's no tension, just relaxing. Relaxing through your face, not holding any tension at all. Feel your eyes relax, eyebrows relax. Feel all the wrinkles fading away from you. Feel the stress fade away. There's no need for stress. What are you stressing about? You're stressing about if you're going to make it to work on time. That's okay. Just be in the moment. There's no need to rush. Find the time to be with you every day. Find the time to meditate. Find your meditation. Your meditation can be going for a walk and mindfully walking. As you're walking, with each step, walk like a Buddha. Feel the ground, feel the dirt and the rocks touching the skin. Feel the wet dew on the grass. Feel how your muscles move when you walk. Feel the breeze upon your skin, the sun upon your face. Feel earth. Feel Mother Nature. Feel everything around you. When you're a child, you live in the moment. You don't have any worries. You're not worrying about the past. And you don't have any hang-ups from the future. You're in the moment. You're in the now. Of being like a Buddha. To be a Buddha or to be a yogi, all you need to do is know how to breathe and be mindful. Focusing on your breath is being mindful. Mindfulness will bring you joy, peace, and love. We're going to take a few moments now in silence, just for us to be you, be happy to be you. Thank yourself and show gratitude daily. You may show with gratitude through these moments of silence.
bowel movements, wiggling your fingers, your toes, rolling your wrists and your ankles, stretching up over your head, your arms stretching out through your legs. Big breath in, big breath out. Lift your legs up. Going to roll over to the side of your choice, whatever feels best for you. Right side is yin, left side is yin. Take a few moments here in stillness. When you're ready, come up to a seated position. Comfortable seated position. Thank you for sharing your yoga practice with me today. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Peace, peace, peace. Namaste, yogis.